Hi, welcome to the WTAMU Virtual Math Lab. This video will step you through College Algebra Tutorial 11, Example 1. In this example, we want to simplify the complex fraction of, in the numerator, 2 over a plus 3 over b, over, in the denominator, of 5 over b minus 6 over a squared. Let's go ahead and use what is called Method 1 in this tutorial to simplify this. In step 1, we want to rewrite the numerator and denominator so that they are each a single fraction. Let's look at the numerator first. We need to combine 2 over a plus 3 over b. The least common denominator here would be ab. We would have to multiply the numerator and denominator of the first fraction by b to get 2b over ab. We would multiply the numerator and denominator of the second fraction by a to get 3a over ab. Now that we have a least common denominator, we can add them to be one fraction of 2b plus 3a over ab. Now let's look at the denominator. We need to subtract 5 over b minus 6 over a squared. The least common denominator here would be a squared b. We would have to multiply the numerator and denominator of the first fraction by a squared to get 5a squared over b a squared. We would have to multiply the numerator and denominator of the second fraction by b to get 6b over a squared b. Now that we have a least common denominator, we can combine them to be one fraction of 5a squared minus 6b all over a squared b. We can put this back into the complex fraction, and when we do this, we get in the numerator 2b plus 3a over ab all over the denominator of 5a squared minus 6b over a squared b. In step 2, we need to divide the numerator by the denominator. We can do this by rewriting this as a multiplication of reciprocal of that denominator. So we can rewrite this as 2b plus 3a over ab times the reciprocal of that denominator, which is a squared b over 5a squared minus 6b. We can write this as one fraction and get 2b plus 3a times that second numerator of a squared b all over AB times that second denominator of 5A squared minus 6B. It looks like we can divide out the common factors of A and B. When we do that, it leads us to our final answer of A times 2b plus 3a all over 5a squared minus 6b. Note that the value that would be excluded from the domain of the original rational expression is 0 for both a and b. This value would make the original denominators equal to 0.